Good morning, guys. So today is an exciting day because I'm going to a barn far out. So basically, Lindsey from Harmony Horsemanship contacted me through YouTube. She has a YouTube channel, so I'll link it down below. And basically, she has super cool videos like training horses and doing more like liberty work, which I thought is really interesting because I don't really have any expertise in that area. Like, I don't really know anything about that. So anyway, she reached out to me and wanted me to like come up to her barn, and not sure what we have planned, but I'm going up there and I guess we're gonna just see where the day takes us. So yeah, I decided to vlog the whole thing, and yeah, so we're gonna leave soon and I'm super excited. So I want to show you guys what I was wearing. To be honest, I don't know if I'm gonna be riding or anything, but I'm thought it'd be safest to just wear riding clothes. So I'm just wearing a Lululemon top. It's like an athletic top. My Unbelt, just the black one, and then my Elation Platinum breeches. Now,
hey guys, thanks for coming.
Yeah, so we're just gonna play around today on the barn and see what we get into, I guess.
Time to let down after the track. They give you from, you can start from December 1st, and then the competition's in October. So that's like 11 months, I guess,
yeah,
that you get to train. So before December 1st, I can't have more than 15 training rides. And I actually bought her, when I did the 2015 makeover, I didn't get her until February. So,
dang.
So she was, time. I was a little bit shorter on time.
Yeah.
But some people do that though.
If you don't have. Yeah.
Really cool.
So then you just work with her through that time, and then there's a show.
Yeah. So I took her to a lot of shows to try to get her ready for that initial one, and then after we won in 2015, she got a role in the movie for Unbridled, which comes out in April.
No way.
So her co-star is my other horse, Dreamer, who's outside.
Gosh.
So he's the main movie star, and then she does a little side party.
Okay, that's so cool. I know, it's hard to just figure out who to learn from, because I have, like, no idea. Do I watch this, like, online or
and I like to tell people there's no right or wrong, there's just options.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So when we're gonna use positive reinforcement, I want you to think, did my horse do something new, something challenging, or something exceptional?
Yeah.
And because you don't know her and you don't know what she can do, most things you're gonna be like, oh, that's new. And then the second thing for that is you're always gonna use a yes word. So you can either say yes or bingo, but she doesn't get a treat unless you use one of those words. And that will help her know not to mug you, because we're not going to give her a treat just because, oh, you're a cute little bear, here's a cookie. It will help, because a lot of people will say, oh, you use treats with your horses, don't they end up with bad manners? But really, we just have to teach them to be polite and put some parameters around it so she's not thinking she's going to always get one.
Okay.
And then the other thing is, if you're going to give a treat, we're not going to let her have it if she's nosing your pockets.
Okay.
So it'd be kind of like, like if you just told me, Lindsey, you're such a good girl, I'm gonna go get you a cupcake, If I was then like, oh, is it vanilla? Is it pumpkin flavored? Is it carrot? Is it right? What could it? Oh, is it right here? Where is it going to be? Like, you'd be like, stop it. Like, don't do that, right? So same thing with her. Like, kind of block your space. So we're not going to get mad at her and like hit her, but think block your space. Okay. So she has to be polite.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay,
that's,
All right. So she's going to come over here. We can offer a hand and let her connect and touch in. She's looking for cookies in the sand. Say hello. If we just kind of extend her hand like this. This is kind of like our target, like our check-in. Good. And then you just take it away. And that's kind of like how we greet. Just like how horses in the field, they would normally sniff noses, but we don't want to do that. So since she's over here, she's kind of asking, well, what can we do? So the first thing I want to show you is how you can do a cheek hold to kind of direct her and show her where you want her to go. Okay.
So if I stand at the side here, all I'm going to do is have my hand just politely here. It's like a little wall. So if I want her to move, I'm going to politely use my fingers and ask her to follow that. But I mean, so polite.
Yeah.
And the coolest thing about trying to work with a horse with no tools is it makes you more aware of how much pressure and how assertive you can be.
Mm-hmm.
So instead of thinking, oh, I'm going to like, you think, you know, just dive.
Yeah.
Okay, so I want you to come over here and try. Stand on the side and you're going to put your hand here. Just on the side. And then I want you to see if you can take her for a little walk by using your hand on the side to simply guide her. And if you want to go forward, yeah. Usually the best way to go forward, you can kind of click to her to add energy or turn. Like kind of, yeah, there you go, like that, good stuff. And then your hand isn't like a wall, it's just guiding, and you're just kind of there, you're following, and then when you go to turn her, you're just kind of making your finger. Yeah. So I like to kind of use a visual of, pretend like your hand is holding a bird. You don't want the bird to fly away, but don't kill your bird. Awesome. See that here? Your bird flew away. Darn it. Shucks. All right. So then how do we get the horse to come back? So she's trying to do something. She's like, you want me to go over a jump, right? She checks back in. So just run backwards and she should follow you. Like literally, yeah, run backwards because that's called a draw. So when you put your belly button on a horse and you move backwards, it usually draws the horse towards you. And try to not let your bird fly away, but don't kill your bird either. So this is a good kind of first exercise to teach horses for working at liberty, because you want to get comfortable having your hands on your horse.
Yeah.
And let them know that it's not going to hurt them and that they can feel comfortable with that. Very nice. How's that feel?
Good. Like, you just kind of have to be always there.
Yeah.
Life goes on long after you and me, but when I hear our song, it's like a time machine. And when the curtain falls, as far as we can see, I hope you'll sing along, go back in time with me. I know that life goes on long after you and me, but when I hear our song, it's like a time machine. And when the curtain falls, as far as we can see, I hope you'll sing along, go back in time with me, time machine.
Objects. So you know how sometimes, like let's say a plastic bag goes rolling through an arena and the horses get scared of it? If you teach them you can push something that's moving, then they start to become less scared.
Yeah.
And if she can be confident with this, then if let's say you're on a trail and they're stuck over top of a log, they can be a problem solver instead of a panicker. So you're going to use your right leg and just keep her straight. And if she steps forward, then you'll just correct that. Good. Very good. Very nice. You're like right in the middle. Very good. Perfect. Perfect. Good job. Awesome. Do you feel like an obstacle queen now? Maybe use your leg. That's okay. So just give her a little bit longer range. I can leave it here and there after. Whenever, like horses, and you're breathing, right? You're breathing and you're smiling. And you could take her over to the pedestal if you want, or over to the ball, and see if you can have enough focus that she can follow that focus. Very good. Nice job. Very cool.
So, it's so crazy.
To think that we jump courses like that?
Yeah. I know, so many people jump driverless, and I'm like, how?
You have to learn to push. Very good. And then fall off. Good job.
Yes.
Just be careful, na-na. Love ain't simple, na-na. Promise me no promises.